Welcome to EPG Parshala on the subject Social Medicine and Community Health. I, Dr. C.P. Mishra, Professor in the Department of Community Medicine, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University, shall be discussing the module National AIDS Control Program. This module belongs to the paper National Health Programs and Policy. This module has been developed by a team comprising of myself, Dr. B.K. Taneja, and Dr. Rupali Barua, and Dr. Banerjee from New Delhi. The learning objectives that has been set for this session is that after going through this session, one should be able to state the problem of HIV and AIDS, should be able to pinpoint modes of transmission of HIV and AIDS, and should be able to identify vulnerable groups who are affected with the disease, and to understand the organizational structure and functioning of National AIDS Control Program, and then last but not least, to be able to identify the goal, objectives, organizational structure, and key achievements of the various phases of National AIDS Control Program. Human immunodeficiency virus is the most serious in the sense because it causes a disease, human immunodeficiency disease, which has had a very old history. In fact, the whole story started in the year 1981 on June 5th, when 5 cases of pneumocystic LI were reported by the Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Reports in Los Angeles. And since then, so many cases of AIDS and HIV occurred in the world that in the year 1914, about 35 million people were living with HIV and AIDS in the world. This immunodeficiency virus is a deadly virus. It belongs to class lentivirus, that is, retroviruses of RNA series, and transcribed to do DNA by reverse transcriptase. The most important property of this virus is it possesses reverse transcriptase, which integrates into the host genome and it has a high potential of genetic diversity, and that is why we cannot create it. Vaccine in a two cells can lie dormant in a cell for many years, especially in the resting CD4 T cells. Now, there are two types of viruses, HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 is a worldwide distribution, causes worldwide pandemic, whereas HIV-2 is isolated from West Africa, has spread in the last decade to India and Europe. HIV-2 is intrinsically resistant to adult HIV prevalence varies from different regions of the world, and as per in the year 2012 figures are projected before you, the maximum adult HIV prevalence was observed in the African region, followed by Americas, and global prevalence has been 0.8%. About 6,300 new HIV infections occurred in a day in the year 2012, and about 95% were in the low and middle income countries, where resource crunch was there, and about 700 are in children under the age of 15 years of age. About 5,500 are in adults aged 15 years and older, of whom about 47% are women, and about 39% are among young people, that is 15 to 24 years. This implies that this disease affects the young and productive population of a country, and in those areas, say for example in Africa, where young and productive populations are affected, where mortality due to HIV rates is very high, the country's economy suffers. As far as Indian scenario is concerned, highest risk group in India is commercial sex workers, men-to-men sex workers, intravenous drug users, where pregnancy is more than 5 years. Then after that, once bridge population comes in contact with them, 2 to 3 years, bridge population is like clients of commercial sex workers, sexually transmitted disease patients, migrant population, population in conflict areas, and partners of IEDs. Then, after a gap of 2 to 3 years, this moves to the general population. So general scenario is that from high risk population, the disease goes to risk population and then it goes to the general population. Now, look in this diagram, the Indian scenario has been described, and there it has been observed that over the period of years from 2007 to 2011, there has been a decrease in the estimated adult HIV prevalence and number of people living with HIV and AIDS. In the year 2007, the prevalence was 0.33%, which declined subsequently, and in 2011 it was 0.27%. Whereas adult persons living with HIV, people living with HIV and AIDS, were around 20.9 lakhs in 2011 against 22.5 lakhs in the year 2007. Of these, females were 39% and children were 7% of the total people living with HIV and AIDS. Immunodeficiency virus causes this disease, and according to level of prevalence, the disease conditions can characterize in the higher prevalence states in India or where high risk group, in the case of high risk group, it is more than 5%. Antenatal positivity is more than 1%. Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Nagaland, and Manipur belong to high prevalence states. The group second is moderate prevalence states, where prevalence in the high risk group is more than 5%, but antenatal care women, it is less than 1%. Gujarat, Goa, and Pondicherry belongs to this group. The third group is low prevalence states, where the prevalence is less than 5% in high risk group, and it is also less than 1% in antenatal care women. Declining trends in adult HIV prevalence are sustained in all the high prevalence states, that is those states where prevalence is more than 5% in high risk group and more than 1% in antenatal group. These states are, as I said earlier, they are Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Manipur, Nagaland, Tamil Nadu. And all these high prevalence states have noted, because of various interventions, declining trend in their adult HIV prevalence, and other states such as Mizoram and Goa. Some states in the north, such as Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Uttarakhand, some in the northwest region, including Punjab, Chandigarh, and Delhi, and some low prevalence of northeast, including Assam, have shown rising trend in the adult HIV prevalence. HIV prevalence trends among general population and high risk group national level 2003 to 2011. Now, in drug users, that is the red bar, it shows that even in 7 to 11 years, the prevalence is on the higher side. Whereas female sex workers, it is a declining trend. NSMM, it is also declining trend. And antenatal care, the positivity is the lowest. Earlier it was high, but it is the lowest. So declining trend has been observed in drug users, female sex workers, NSM workers over the period of time. As per annual report of National AIDS Control Organization 2012 and 13, considerable decline in HIV prevalence has been recorded among female sex workers at national level, which was 5.06% in 2007. It has come to 2.67 in the year 2011, and in most of the states where long-standing targeted interventions have focused on behavioral change and including condom use. Declines have been also observed in HIV prevalence among MSMM, men to men sex workers, 7.41% in 2007. From that figure, it has come to 4.43% in 2011. So several pockets in the country show higher HIV prevalence among them with mixed trends. Transgenders are also emerging as a risk group with high vulnerability and high levels of HIV. Stable trends have been recorded using drug users at the national level, 7.23% in 2007 to 7.14%. So the decline in this group has not been substantial. Evidence of program impact can be assessed by declining trends of new HIV infections and AIDS-related deaths in India. Now, overall, it has been observed that there has been 57% reduction in the new infections over a period of 11 years from 2000 to 2011. It's a scale-up preventive strategy. Estimated adult new HIV infections have, in terms of number of lakhs, say for example, initially it was more, in 2001 it was around 2.4, and it has come down to less than 1.5, and it is just above 1 lakhs. So it says that in spite of increasing number of population, there has been substantial decrease in the estimated adult new HIV infections. There has been 29% reduction in the AIDS-related deaths over a period of 2007 to 11. It's a scale-up of antiretroviral treatment. Not only that, the number of cases have declined. With the implementation of antiretroviral therapy, the discrimination that was attached to HIV and AIDS are gradually eliminated. It is getting to disappear, and many people have started realizing that it is also a disease that with antiretroviral therapy and long survival with antiretroviral therapy, the scenario is changing very fast. As far as just now we have discussed about HIV virus, which is a very notorious virus because it has transcriptase enzyme, it attaches with the host cells. Now, as far as host characteristics are concerned, A is particularly sexually active young person, 20 to 49 years old. Children less than 15 years make up or less than 3% of cases. 51% in homosexuals or bisexuals, West American and European Australia is equal in Africa. Generally, when the disease passes from the highest group to the general population, the sex differences or gender differences disappear. High-risk groups are MSM, FSM, drug users, multiple sexual partners, transfusion recipients, and STD patients. In fact, initially the disease was confined to four heterosexual and homosexuals. Second H is heroin addicts, that is drug users. Third H is refers to hemophiliacs, that is those who are receiving multiple transfusions, and last is horizontal transmission, mother to child transmission. Reservoirs are cases and care, yes, both. It has been observed that cases, particularly at the extremes of it, initially and the terminal phases, are highly infectious. Serum, CSF, tears, saliva, cervical and vaginal secretions. Only blood and semen have been conclusively proved to be a source for transmitting the disease. It has been observed that the penetrative partner has less risk than the receiving partner, particularly in the heterosexual behavior. Modes of transmission in India and vis-a-vis USA, if you look at that, heterosexual mode is the commonest mode in India. About 88% cases in India are due to heterosexual route. Parent-to-child transmission is on rise, is 5%. Homosexuals, 1.5%. Infectious syringes and needles contribute to 1.7% total cases, and blood products are around 1%, not specified modes are 2.7%. If you look at the efficacy of transmission of different modes, the blood transfusion has the highest efficacy. That is, if HIV positive blood is transfused to 100 people, more than 95% will be HIV positive in times to come. Heterosexual behavior, the efficacy of transmission is around 1%, 200 or 0.5 to 1%. It means 200 sexual contacts with HIV partner will lead to one or two cases maximum. So, contrary to Indian scenario, in USA, 63% cases are because of MSM, 25% are heterosexual behavior, 8% drug user, and 3% MSM plus drug users. So, according to from country to country, the mode of transmission varies. These two diagrams simply highlights that. Now, control of acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, there are four basic approaches. First is prevention. Second is education. Third is prevention of blood-borne HIV transmission. Antiretroviral treatment and specific prophylaxis and primary health care. National AIDS Control Program has been integrated in the country's primary health care system. So there has been a decentralization of this. Organization structure of National AIDS Control Program. District AIDS Control Program units are there. On top of that, state AIDS Control Societies are there. And at the top, there is the Department of AIDS Control, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. At the central level, we have Secretary of Government of India, who is assisted by Joint Secretary 1, Deputy Director General 6, Assistant Director General 1, Joint Director 1, Deputy Secretary 1. At the state level, we have Project Director, which is of the rank of generally an administrative officer. Then additional project directors are there. And at the district level, we have AIDS Control Officer and District Program Management Officer. Now, National AIDS Control Program has four distinct phases. After the occurrence of the first case in, reporting of first case in the year 1986 in India from CMC Vellore, Government of India started established the board, and subsequently it was converted into National AIDS Control Program, which was initiated in 1992 with World Bank assistance for a period of 5 years, from the year 1992 to 1997. And this phase was further extended to up to March 1999. So the National AIDS Control Program Phase 1, which was from the year 1992 to 1999, had very specific objectives. The first objective was to slow the spread of HIV and AIDS, to decrease the mortality and morbidity due to HIV infection, and to minimize the socioeconomic impact due to HIV and AIDS. Because this disease was a very, at the initial time, there was a lot of social discrimination, stigma attached to this disease, and any death due to HIV and AIDS was viewed very seriously by the society. Then expansion of infrastructure of blood banks, because blood bank, realizing the fact that the efficacy of transmission of blood, HIV blood, positive blood, leads to more than 95% of conditions. The efficacy was quite high, and this was a potential mode through which HIV transmission can be checked. So blood banks or blood safety program was taken on a very higher scale. Creation of infrastructure for treatment of STDs in district hospitals and medical colleges. It was realized by some studies conducted in Tanzania that if a person is suffering from STD and has a sexual contact with HIV person, the chance of transmission is 9 times higher. And therefore, STDs, which was almost a forgotten agenda, got special impetus. Syndromic management of sexually transmitted diseases was brought in the ambit of National AIDS Control Program and through the primary health care system. Initiation of HIV sentinel surveillance system in the country to monitor the trends of the disease in the high-risk groups as well as in the general population. High-risk groups were through STD clinics, and also through those people who are involved in special behaviors, and for general population, the reference was taken as antenatal women. Creation of a state AIDS cells in the then phase 2 after 1999, the phase 2 was started implemented in the year from 1999 to 2006 work, and in this phase, the basic emphasis was to reduce the spread of HIV infection in India, particularly from high-risk groups to general population, to strengthen India's capacity to tackle HIV AIDS on the long-term basis, shifting focus from raising awareness to general population. Awareness was considered a basic instrument in the first phase to change the behavior through targeted interventions, particularly among drug users, drug drivers, sexually transmitted patients attending sexual STD clinics, and also in the commercial sex workers in the red light areas. So targeted intervention was considered as a main instrument, because every attempt was made that the British population is coming in contact with the high-risk group should somehow, it is checked that the disease should not pass through the general population, because once it goes through the general population, it will be difficult to control. Then decentralization of service to delivery to the states and conceptualization of school aids control education program, because it has been observed that if school children are informed about this, at least 50% of the diseases are directly transmitted by the school children to their families. And establishment of BCT facilities in healthcare facilities, voluntary testing facilities in the health centers at the different health facilities. Particularly, it was said that mandatory testing should not be enforced, and people should be educated, and they given opportunities for voluntary testing and counseling and screening. And intervention for PPCT, parent-to-child transmission was checked, because it was observed that it is easier to control from transmission from parents to children, particularly during antenatal, and then free ARTs to all patients to enhance their survival and to improve their quality of life, so that people can believe that it is not it is just like any other disease, because just like cancer or any other disease, and the stigma that has been attached to this was getting gradually eliminated. So these were the strategies during phase two. Then from 2007 onwards till 2012, this program, National AIDS Control Program, entered into phase three. And in the phase three, there was a clear-cut goal to halt and reverse the epidemic in India over the 5 years by integrating programs of prevention, care, support, and treatment. So, reversal of epidemic trend, and then it involved particularly four strategies. One, prevent infection through saturation of high-risk group, through targeted interventions, scale-up interventions in general population. Provide greater care, support, and treatment to people living with HIV and AIDS. And strengthen the infrastructure, systems, and human resources in prevention, care, support, and treatment of the program at district, state, and national level. Then strengthen the basic management information system, strategic information management system, so that we should be very clear that where we stand and where should we move, and what are the hurdles in moving, and what are the priority areas where attention needs. Services for prevention were, whatever services that we provided, blood safety has to be ensured, integrated counseling and testing centers were created, ICTC, and prevention of parent-to-child transmission, sexually transmitted disease and reproductive infection services were promoted on the same logic that targeted interventions among high-risk group and risk population is to be reduced, information, education, communication, particularly BCC, behavioral change communication. And people were it was emphasized that as far as condom promotion, particularly at many places, there are messages that was given that one should be loyal to his partner, must practice safe sex, particularly use of condoms was encouraged. It was popularly said that earlier we were using condoms for prevention of births, now you are using condoms for prevention of deaths. So care, support, and treatment to the people living with HIV and AIDS. Antiretroviral therapy for this purpose, medical colleges have been identified, district link, ART centers have been opened in the country. And in order to see that opportunistic infections with AIDS, particularly in our country, is TB is very common. And for people with HIV and TB, they are a very difficult case to treat. And therefore, emphasis has been provided that all opportunistic infections, whether it is tuberculosis or or other diseases that should be taken care of. Post-exposure prophylaxis, particularly in the settings where operations are being performed by surgeons on a particular HIV patient, if they have any exposure, then post-exposure prophylaxis should be provided within 72 hours. Community care centers have been also envisaged. Now, we are running in the phase 4, National AIDS Control Program Phase 4, which was launched on 12th February 2014. The aim of this phase is to accelerate the process of epidemic reversal and further strengthening epidemic response in India through a cautious and well-defined mitigation process over the 5-year period. The idea is that whatever gains we have achieved through previous phases, not only that should be strengthened, the response of the government, particularly epidemic response of it, so brought to that level that there should be complete epidemic reversal. Objective is to reduce new infections by 50%, provide comprehensive care and support to all people living with HIV/AIDS, and treatment services for all those who are required. So 3x5 initiatives were started and so many things were done. Conferences intensifying and consolidated prevention services with a focus on high-risk groups and vulnerable population. High-risk groups are subjects that are confined to specific pockets like red light areas. Homosexuals are confined to a particular area. But truck drivers and other groups, they are passing from one place in the country to another place in the country. So at the vulnerable populations, particularly bridge populations who are coming in contact with high-risk groups, that needs a special attention so that the disease should not be carried out to the general population. Because it is the bridge population that comes into the high-risk group and that brings the disease to the general population. Extending IEC for behavioral change communication. In fact, we have to move from IEC to behavioral change communication for high-risk groups with a focus on behavioral change and demand generation for condom and other services. General population need to be educated also, because then they will take preventive measures, particularly they will practice safe sex. Increasing access in promoting care, support and treatment to all persons who are HIV positive. One of the unfortunate thing is that many people who are HIV, carrying virus HIV in their blood, they are not aware they are HIV positive. This is causing a lot of problem in the control. Building capacities at national, state, district and facility level. Then strategic information management system that has to be strengthened, because one must be very sure that where we are moving, we are we moving in the right direction or not, and accordingly we can take modify our strategy. Eligibility for receiving antiretroviral therapy has been revised from CD4 level of 350 to 500. And introduction of the third line ART for all those who failed on second line ART has been instituted. New initiatives under the National AIDS Control Program Phase 4, differential strategies for districts based on data triangulation with due weightage to vulnerabilities. So vulnerability analysis has been done. Data coming from various sources has been collected and data triangulation has been undertaken. And based on that, differential strategies have been evolved for the steps. The scaling up of the programs to target key vulnerabilities and scale up of opioid substitution therapy for drug users so that they can be brought into the strict control from, because most of the drug users are very, it's very difficult to leave their, for them it is very difficult to leave their drugs. Scale up of strengthening of migrant interventions at source, transit and destinations. Female condom program has to be instituted, because many people, particularly visiting commercial sex workers, they don't use condoms. So female condom program may pay dividends. Multi-drug regimens for PPTCT, that is parent-to-child transmission, keeping with international standards. Even breastfeeding issues has to be resolved, because particularly in the developed countries, they follow that. But in our country, we promote, because there are certain basic advantages associated with breastfeeding. But one has to take into consideration that exclusive breastfeeding has to be promoted, because mixed feeding, formula feeding, along with breastfeeding will be more dangerous. Social protection for marginalized population through earmarking budgets for HIV among concerned government departments. Marginalized populations suffering from HIV and AIDS, their social protection is very, very vital. Unless that is done, probably people who are in the marginalized populations and they suffer from HIV and AIDS, they will adopt other strategies which is not conducive. Establishment of metro blood banks and plasma fractionation centers. In fact, on the blood safety, a lot of efforts have been taken by the government of India. And demand promotion strategies, especially using multimedia, national folk media, campaign armor mode, express, that is ribbon space and buses, and other conversions are under NRHM. Many newer initiatives have been already taken up so that awareness has built up, demand strategies for testing, for ART, BPAT. Scale up of the second line of drugs, because first line of drugs they become resistant, then we have to go for. Marginalized populations are victims of HIV and AIDS, and once they get affected, their social conditions further gets jeopardized, and therefore their social protection becomes very, very vital. Mechanisms should be evolved by the governments, departments to accord social protection to these marginalized groups. Establishment of metro blood banks and plasma fractionation centers is desired, and demand generation for testing for antiretroviral drugs be created, as it has been done by adopting various approaches like national folk media campaigns, then red ribbon express on messages on buses, and also in the utilizing various multimedia approaches. Then scaling up of the second line of drugs is also desired, because maybe first line of drugs will, if they lose their potency, then that should be available. A number of services are being offered as a package, and preventive services are targeted interventions for high risk group and bridge population, truckers and migrants. Needle syringes exchange program and opioid substitution therapy for drug users. Prevention, interventions for migrant population at source, transient and destination. Link worker scheme for high-risk groups and vulnerable population in rural areas. Prevention and control of STI and RTI. Blood safety, HIV counseling and testing services. Parent to child transmission control program. Condom promotion. Then IEC and behavioral change communication strategies, social mobilization, youth interventions and adolescence education program, ministering HIV and disease response, and workplace safety, and so on. Then the second group of a package involves care, support and treatment services. Laboratory services for CD4 count testing and other investigations are available at RRT centers. Free first line and second line antiretroviral viral treatment through ART centers and link ART centers and ART plus co centers. Pediatric ART for children has to be instituted, because a significant proportion of our children are also getting affected with this. Early infant diagnosis for HIV exposed infants and children below 18 months. Nutritional and psychosocial support through community care centers, because nutrition plays a very important role in the quality of AIDS victims. HIV-TB coordination, cross-referral, detection and treatment of co-infections, and even it is envisaged that at the ART center itself, the anti-TB drugs may be available. Treatment of opportunistic infections that will improve the deterioration of the patients, and drop-in centers for people living in HIV and AIDS. Then a strategic information management system includes a number of initiatives. That is knowledge products, knowledge sharing, knowledge transition, pre-program assessments, in-program assessment and program evaluation. So different processes, different systems, subsystems of the program needs to be evaluated, and framework for strategic information and management under National AIDS Control Program 4 have been worked out. Third line ART drugs, salvage or rescue therapy for double resistant HIV. Criteria is patient who have failed at least two previous anti-HIV regimens and are people with evidence of HIV resistance to at least one drug in each of the three major classes. The third line treatment centers will be established soon. Program will be in the place within 6 months. The drug procuring process is going on and cost will be very high. Cost will be around 15,000 per person per month. HIV AIDS Prevention Control Bill 2014 was presented in Rajya Sabha in February 2014. Provide protection to HIV AIDS vector-affected people against discrimination in education, healthcare, employment, travel and insurance, and both in public and private sector. The provisions are Rs. 10,000 fine and 2 years imprisonment for those who found guilty of spreading hatred against people living with HIV. ART will be provided free of cost to all patients by government, and right privacy and confidence of HIV and her status, with some exceptions, will prevail. So just to conclude that since 1981, the first case, first five cases of sister pneumonia and first case of HIV in the year 1986 in India, the substantial number of cases have occurred in the country. Mechanisms have been evolved for their control and reversal trends are there. Still, the disease is at a high, very high magnitude. And in the National AIDS Control Program Phase 4, all attempts are being have been initiated so that there should be the reversal of trend in the total cases of HIV and AIDS in India. And also, in order to improve the quality of life, measures have been initiated in terms of ART and other support services for people, particularly nutrition care and so on, so that people can live with dignity and prestige and their rights are being protected in place of work and other social places. Thank you very much for visiting EPG Patsala.